Hi, my name is Curtis Anderson, and I'm a senior software architect with Panassus, and I'm here to describe a little bit about a new feature in our PanFS file system called dynamic data acceleration. I'm going to start with the hardware and software combination and that in our product, and then I'm going to give you an overview of a traditional architecture and then compare and contrast the two. We have a marketing claim that this is all hot, all the time, without the cost of all flash. And I'll explain that as I go along and try to support it. So let's start with the hardware. So the Active Store Ultra chassis has 6 hard drives in it, and they're really good at delivering bandwidth if you give them large transfers, meaning large files. It has a traditional flash in it, and that's really good if you give it small transfers for small files. It has an NVMe flash in it that's really good at very low latency, very small transfers. And then it has an NVDIMM stick, that is a non-volatile piece of DRAM, and that is extremely low latency. So let me describe how we use these, and then we'll talk about the effect of that. So a transaction comes in from a client, goes into the NVDIMM. The data and metadata is logged into the NVDIMM, and the application goes on its way. Then all the rest happens asynchronously. We're going to read and write metadata from the NVMe drive as necessary. If it's a small file, it's going to go into the flash. If it's a large file, it's going to go to the hard drives. If the flash is underutilized, it's less than about 80% full, we'll take the smallest things from the hard drive and move them up to the flash. If the flash is overutilized, above 80%, we'll take the largest things from there and move them down to the hard drive. That keeps those two groups in balance. Altogether, this is really good at supporting mixed workloads, because if you have a lot of large files, we have the devices that are good at that. If you have a lot of small files, we have a storage device that's good at that. If you have a mixed workload environment, we have some of each, then we've got you covered. If your workload changes over time, then this architecture adapts, because we have the mixed workload performance and we'll keep that flash about 80% full, maximizing its value to you. Okay, so that's sort of our architecture. Over here, I'll draw a sort of traditional architecture. So that has, in a hot tier, 1.3 petabytes of NVMe flash. That's high performance. Then it has 40 petabytes of S3 archive below it. So that's about 3% of the total and about 97% of the total in the cold archive. The application is going to see 135 gigabytes a second out of the hot tier, but they're not going to get any contribution from the cold tier because the application can't access the cold tier. That cost Genomics England $400 a terabyte. If we were to try to meet the same customer requirement with an Active Store Ultra design, we would provide 410 petabytes of, 41 petabytes of storage. We would deliver 410 gigabytes per second worth of bandwidth out of that storage. That's 3 times the bandwidth you would get out of the traditional architecture. And that would be delivered at $200 a terabyte rather than $400 per terabyte. So that's 6 times the price performance compared to a traditional architecture because of the architecture. We're not using any particular devices that are special, just we're using them in a way that is better than the traditional structure. So I made the claim at the beginning that we had all hot all the time without all flash. We're delivering 6 times the price performance than the traditional architectures, and so we believe that's a really good claim that'll benefit you, the customer. If you'd like to hear more about it, please contact us. Thanks.